Hello everybody, my name is Hayley Francis Cann. I am a certified music therapist, a neurologic music therapist, currently working in the Kingston, Ontario, Cataraqui area in Canada. And I'm here at the Music Museum to share a little bit about myself and how I incorporate music in my professional life. So I grew up in Bermuda, which is a small island just off of the United States, and you know, because it's so close in proximity, I got to travel all over the place and be influenced by many different styles of music. But growing up, I didn't really understand that there was more that I could pursue at a professional level other than being a music teacher or a music performer. And when I was researching programs to study in university, I actually stumbled across music therapy. And I've met so many people throughout my walk of life who have had the same question as I did back then. What is music therapy? What is it? So I decided that I would go and study it, and I learned more and more about it, and now I am practicing music therapy mostly in long-term care, but I also serve clients that are recovering from brain injury and children that have autism or on the spectrum of some kind. And you know, even though I'm practicing now, I'm still met with lots of people who are unsure about what this profession is and how it can benefit so many people. And so I decided to write a book. So I guess I'm a new author, and it's called Mandy's Mom, the Music Therapist. And I wanted to share a little bit about this book with you today. I'm going to read some of it for you. Being a music therapist, I really felt it was valuable to make the storyline have rhythm and rhyme so that it lends itself easy to any melody that you want to put on top of it. And so you can sing it however you like. The melody that I sing today is not a universal melody. I encourage you to get a copy for yourself and to choose your own melody to sing along, you know, to the storyline. And it's basically just a story that's going to tell us all about what I do in my work at long-term care. But it's also very universal to a lot of other populations that you'll see music therapists working in. So here we go. Mandy's Mom, the Music Therapist. Mandy's teacher told her students to perform a special task, learn about an exciting job, and share it with the class. Mandy thought both long and hard about what she would do. Maybe she could ask her mom what music therapists do. Her mom is a music therapist, but Mandy has no clue what that means. She is cool and makes people smile. At least that's how it seems. Mandy decides she'll ask her mom to join her at work one day. Of course, she says, and Mandy replies, hippity hip hooray. Mandy's mom plays the guitar, sings and plays the drums. Mandy's mom feels the rhythm in her fingers and her thumbs. Mandy's mom likes to help anyone she can, feel their best, take requests, and lend a helping hand. All right, I'm gonna skip through some of this because actually, by listening to this YouTube video, you'll have the chance to win a copy of Mandy's Mom, the Music Therapist. We'll be giving away two copies. I'll skip to some of my favorite pages. Many of the people here have left their homes for good, said goodbye to all they knew and never understood why they had to leave the home they worked for all their lives. Music helps them to restore their long lost sense of pride. Music therapy gives people choices and encourages participation. This stimulates their brain and bones with a musical invitation. Music therapists can guide the change from a sad to a cheerful mood by counseling and listening and being the friend that redirects the tune. I note the way they interact with others during the music. Sometimes they remember through song memories they were losing. These things are all a part of learning what music therapists do. I hope that you have learned enough to share in class at school. Mandy couldn't wait to share all that she had learned. Her mom had the most amazing job as far as she was concerned. She said, "My mom helps other people to feel their very best. She counsels and supports without judgment or prejudice. Everyone is equal and deserves to live with pride. No matter what the struggle is, music therapists are on your side." So that's the end, and I only read a bit of it for you, just a little taste of what is a part of this book and some of the key points and understanding more about what music therapy is as a profession. And it's not just for children. I wrote this in a children's book format just because I think that everybody learns differently, and I wanted to include very vibrant illustrations to go along with the storyline so that you could better understand what it might look like in a therapy setting. So thank you to my fabulous illustrator, Vanessa Alexandre, who did these wonderful illustrations for me. But also in the back, I have some more resources for you to find out a little bit more about what music therapy is. So I have some facts, I have some common points of fiction. Sometimes people think that only slow and reflective music is therapeutic. That's not true. Some people also believe that receivers of music therapy must be musically talented for it to be effective. That is absolutely not true. We all have a connection to music in some form or fashion, so you don't have to have a history of music or a history of playing musical instruments in order for music therapy to be effective. Along that same vein, some people also think that you have to have previous music experience to participate in music therapy. Anybody can come as long as you have a reason for coming to therapy, just like you would go to talk therapy or play therapy or physiotherapy even. You would come to music therapy with those same goals in mind, and we would just use the music as a medium. So just like those therapies, you don't need to have previous experience before you can be qualified to attend. And lastly, Some people also believe that anybody can administer clinical music therapy. That is false. You have to go through a certain process. In Canada and the States, it's a very rigorous process. You go and you do a degree program in university, and then you complete an internship and then a board certified examination before you can become fully certified. In the UK, I think it's also a similar process. In Australia and around the world, you know, the difference is that we have all of this knowledge, we have all of this evidence-based research at our fingertips that we have looked through, we have learned about, and we can use to support somebody that is in therapy and support whatever comes up within that therapeutic setting. I also have here some of the reasons why we might use music as a therapeutic medium rather than talking or exercising, you know, similar to those other therapies that I mentioned. Why would we use music to reach some of these physical, emotional, cognitive, even social and musical goals sometimes even? So this is why I've given you 6 reasons, but I challenge you to come up with your own after you've read this list or after you've win these books that I'm going to sign for you. And there are also some more resources in the back here of, you know, information about some of the websites you can visit to learn a little bit more about what music therapy is and to read more about me. If you'd like to find out more about me and what I do and connect with me, you can find me on social media on Facebook and Instagram at MTA Hayley.